pour discuter du niveau d'appropriation par
l'État. In order to discuss the level of ownership by the states regarding sustainable development goals, as well as the role played by civil society in the process, one should note that Agenda 2030, although it was in line with the Universal Declaration of Human Rights or the international frameworks relative to human rights, it is not binding and governments are under no obligation to comply with it. The only international follow-up mechanism to monitor commitments made by the states and the progress accomplished towards implementing the goals is the United Nations High-Level Political Forum held each year in July in New York. This global forum is also combined with regional forums, which take place a few months previously in order to analyze advancement and prepare for the global forum. During both the regional and global forum, countries must present reports on a voluntary basis, focusing on a limited number of goals and highlighting the progress made in a very synthetic way, as they only have 30 minutes available to deliver the presentation, which leaves room for arbitrary decisions, partial presentations, and any kind of bias in favor of this or that objective, while preventing countries from presenting overall progress and establishing links between the various goals. As players from civil society, we are always present on the regional, global, and national level to support the states as active players in implementing the goals, but also to monitor progress, which is our role, and we're there to remind the states of their commitments. Our part consists in analyzing the information provided, requesting that the voice of citizens be heard, and ensuring that commitments are fulfilled. To illustrate what I'm saying, I will use several resources, reports from civil society representatives, but also institutional reports, notably the report submitted this year by a group of civil society organizations, including FORES, previously known as FIP. The report is entitled Progression in the SDG Implementation on the National Level, and it focuses mainly on reports presented by the states in 2017, but also on counter reports presented by the civil society of the same states. Second source is the report on Sustainable Development Goals 2018, presented during the summer of 2018 by the UN. This report tries to take the stock of the situation regarding the goals, but has its limit, and it presents an alarming situation because we observe that there is not enough information available to conduct an in-depth analysis. Most of the figures are either presented for the beginning of the century, or they date back to 2015, and we understand that now we don't have an exact picture of the state of advancement of the regional goals. In order to look at the situation in the various countries and understand the level of ownership by the states and all the efforts they have made, we are going to look at several aspects connected with an Agenda 2030. The first is the incorporation of the 2030 agenda in the national policies and frameworks. Most countries present reports, especially those in which were presented in 2017, and they establish a connection between existing policies and Agenda 2030. But we realize that there are very few new policies being created to match the SDGs, and very few efforts are made by the states in order to take in consideration the transversal aspects of Agenda 2030, such as universality, the connection with climate change, or the principle according to which we don't want to leave anybody behind. Practical recommendations. We, civil society, are asking the states to integrate the priorities of Agenda 2030 in the political policies and national frameworks and to connect explicitly each SDG's implementation with national frameworks and international frameworks with regard to human rights. Another interesting aspect has to do with the leadership in the institutional mechanisms and governance. 3 years after Agenda 2030 was adopted, we have seen that many more countries have implemented mechanisms, councils, committees, very often under the control of the ministry, to implement the objectives. And in a limited number of cases, it involves the parliament. Including non-governmental players in this process is unfortunately very limited. And even when it does happen, the non-governmental players are invited to attend subject-oriented discussions, but they have no access to strategic decisions and the real leadership in the process. Regarding best practices and recommendations, we are requesting formal integration of non-governmental players in the government's governance structures in order to contribute to inclusion and an integrated approach in the Agenda 2030 process. Another aspect is everything that has to do with reference data and the analysis of gaps. Countries have declared that they use assessment policies in order to inform their SDG-related approaches, but if we look in detail, we see that there is very little available regarding the results of the assessment. We need to acquire a better understanding on the situation regarding data and research on the implementation of Agenda 2030 so that we can analyze the government policies and understand what kind of data could be provided coming from citizens or research institutions. Another best practice and recommendation, we are requesting that policies be assessed, that data, reference data be made available so that the process is entirely transparent and that we have a very clear idea regarding the priorities for Agenda 2030. We're also asking the states to work on with a evidence-based approach based on figures and results. Another very important aspect, integration and consistency of policies. As I was saying at the beginning of my presentation, during the annual report, states focus almost always on a limited number of goals. And therefore, the information are only presented in a partial way. We do not have an analysis overarching all 17 goals, taking in consideration all the transversal aspects of the agenda. It does not allow us to conduct an in-depth analysis regarding the consistency between all sustainable development-related policies. There is no connection between internal policies and foreign policies in the countries in order to understand the impact of each action taken by each country regarding SDG implementation on the neighboring countries' actions or the partner countries' actions, which is really detrimental because it does not allow us to understand fully all the aspects relating to the agenda. To take this one step further, I would like to say that very few countries in their analysis and reports introduce the connections between the Paris Agreement on climate change or the Addis Ababa program connected with funding of development. We're asking a detailed evaluation of all 17 SDGs, including identification on the connections with all dimensions of sustainable development, referring to national and international efforts to fulfill Agenda 2030. Another very important element, something really complex, has to do with the commitment taken by stakeholders in the national policies, but also the implementation and monitoring process for SDGs implementation. We're talking about the states, but as was said in the preamble of Agenda 2030, the states are not the only stakeholders and the only accountable players to guarantee the success of our ambitions. There are non-governmental players, and I'd like to refer to civil society players because they have an important role to play, and they have the capacity to make the citizens' voice heard in institutions which are normally closed and do not give access to citizens and are not easy to understand for most people. In the reports presented by the states, very often they refer to consultations taking place to define priorities and set priorities, or in order to lay out annual reports. But when we try to go in depth, we find very little detail regarding the content of the consultations, their results, and the influence that non-governmental players had during the consultations. Moreover, these reports do not refer to a favorable environment for civil society. We're fully aware that in the vast majority of countries, the conditions for civil society to thrive are lacking, there is lack of freedom, and obviously this has to do with the country's development and the fulfillment of Agenda 2030. This being said, we are happy to tell you that civil society is mobilizing very, very strongly on the national, regional, international level. There are consultations, there are non-governmental organization groups forming in many different countries. And every time a country submits an official report to the United Nations, civil society coalitions present counter reports in order to strike a balance and sometimes even contradict the official report. Another best practice and recommendation regarding non-governmental players' inclusion in the processes, we ask for consultations with local stakeholders under different formats, and for civil society organizations, we are requesting that they have access to official participation in more transparent processes, consultations for policy implementation, and for the assessment and monitoring of Agenda 2030 implementation. We are requesting specific support to allow civil society to become involved, focusing on larger capacities so that civil society can really make the citizens' voice heard. Right now, we are obliged to accept the fact that there is a single official monitoring system, the High-Level Political Forum, which does not get much attention from the media. And this allows the countries to evade the monitoring regarding Agenda 2030. As civil society representatives, we make constant efforts to mobilize people, to keep them informed, and we inform all the players in society who are looking for allies. There are coalitions currently forming with universities, with players from private society and the private sector, and we try to put pressure on states to make sure that they fulfill the commitments they have taken regarding Agenda 2030 implementation. Thank you.
Pour la mise en œuvre de l'agenda 2030.